Good morning, YouTube. So it's been just about a year since I installed the tankless water heater in the garage, and I wanted to give you an update. It is working fine. No problems with hot water in the winter. Didn't notice any real difference in gas consumption, and I'll show you that next. Big benefit of the tankless heater is I now have room for this really nice utility sink where the old tank type heater used to be, and I have storage underneath, plenty of storage under there. So the utility sink has been a really nice addition out here, just really handy for rinsing things off. And the other thing I like about it, because it's so big, you can take this, it's like a 3 gallon bucket, and put it down in there, fill it up with water if you want to make up some soapy water or mix up something like that. You know, I use that bucket when I descale the tankless heater. I can mix up water to wash vehicles or wash windows, whatever you want to do. So that has been just really nice. You know, I've been wanting that for 30 years, and I finally had a place to put it once I got rid of the old tank. So let's go take a look at the utility bills. We can take a look at the gas consumption of this heater versus the old 40-gallon tank heater that used to be there. Okay, so I thought I'd take a look at a year-over-year comparison of my natural gas bills with the tank heater and the tankless. So I collected my utility bills for the period May through April, and with the tank heater, that was 2016 and 2017, and with the tankless, it was the same months in 2017 and 2018. The tank heater here used between 3 and 4 therms of gas during the warmer summer months, 5 to 6 therms in the cooler winter months. So there's my gas bills. I don't know what happened on this month. It showed 4 therms and they only billed me $1.27. I think there must have been a problem in their billing system that month, because here it was $4, $3, and then that one was $1.27. But anyway, I added up the total for the whole year with the tank heater. 12 months used 54 therms, total cost of $56.67. Then I put the tankless in, and it basically used 0 or 1. I used 9 therms for the whole year. Total cost, $33.60. And I have that plotted over here on the side. The blue is the tank heater, and the orange color is the tankless. And in December, you can see something changed. And what happened was the gas supplier that I had been using finally implemented their customer charge. So that charge is $5 a month, but it's billed as 16.7 cents per day. So depending on how many days are in that billing cycle, it'll be a little bit different. And in order to get a good comparison, I purposely kept that account active. I kept using the same supplier because I wanted to get 12 months of gas consumption on the tankless heater and be able to compare the bills. So what I did was I separated out the customer charge, so it was anywhere from $3.34 up to $5.34. So out of the total gas bill for the past year that was $33.60, $23.55 of that was service charge or customer charge. So my net cost for gas to compare to this number, which didn't have any service charge, was $10.05. And then the tankless heater, of course, requires some electric energy. So the cost for electricity I calculated as $3.46. So the total cost of operating the tankless heater was $13.51, which is a savings of $43.16. That's pretty much in line with the $40 I had estimated last year when I was figuring out the cost. So the tankless heater itself cost about $200 more than replacing the old tank with a new tank heater. And then I spent about $200 on valves and plumbing and various parts to get the tankless installed. So my
added cost of the tankless unit was about $400. And if I'm saving $40 to $45 a year, that'll pay back in maybe 9 or 10 years. And if gas rates continue to go up, the payback will be quicker. And in terms of just gas savings, that's over an 83% reduction in my natural gas use. 9 therms went to heating water and almost zero went to heating up the garage. With the tank type heater, 45 of those therms were used to heat the air in the garage. In December, the third party gas supplier that I had been purchasing gas from for the last 10 years or so finally rolled this customer charge on to existing customers. They didn't actually send out any notice on that. I just, all of a sudden, bills that were $1 were now $5. So I decided in May that I would look at going back to my utility and purchasing gas just directly from them. So let's take a look at the numbers that I worked out to see if that made sense. Okay, so I went to the utility, which is Pacific Gas and Electric. And if you search around on their website, you can find what they call their gas tariff rate. So essentially, this has all their residential rate calculation information here for mobile homes and multifamily apartment buildings and all the various options here. So this is what the residential rates are calculated from. I won't go into all the details, but they do have this per day transportation or delivery charge. So there's basically a 10 cent a day or $3 a month minimum transportation charge, as they call it here. So PG&E has two basic rates. There's the basic non-care rate, which is the full retail price, and then they have this care program, which I'll talk about a little later, that's about a 20% discount. So anyway, they have this minimum charge. You're paying 37 cents per therm for the gas, and then you're paying this transportation or delivery charge, about 92 cents for baseline and $1.47 for excess. That adds up to a total of $1.29 for baseline gas, $1.84 for over baseline or excess. Here's the care discount, so you get about 26 cents off for the care program, which gives you $1.03 or $1.47. And then there's this additional charge, I think, that gets added, this public purpose program surcharge, whatever that is. And they have all these footnotes here. And this is really complicated, so I tried to break it down into what I think your bill would be. So let's take a look at that. Okay, so I took that previous spreadsheet data and I tried to put it into a single page here with some calculated gas bills based on different number of therms that you used. Anyway, what I did was I put the center point charge over here. So they have a $5 customer fee. They charge 42 cents for the gas. They have a negotiated delivery charge price with the utility. So I pay 79 cents for delivery, which results in $1.21 per therm for gas that I use, plus the $5 customer fee. Now, PG&E has this $2.96 delivery charge for retail customers. I don't believe that applies to care customers. Then the gas is 30 or 37 cents, which is actually less than what CenterPoint charges, but the delivery charge is higher. And so your net cost, $1.10 on care and $1.38 on the retail. And then I looked at what kind of consumption would you need to make up this $5 customer fee. With care, you'll never break even. You're always paying more. If you're paying full retail on the residential rate, if you exceed 30 therms, you've made up that $5. So if your average, not your average bill, but every single bill is at least 30 therms, it might make sense to use one of these third-party suppliers like CenterPoint. But if you're using less than 30, it may not make sense. Now, the one thing I did not figure out was the baseline and excess charges. In the summer, the baseline allowance is 18 therms. In the winter, you get 60 therms. I think CenterPoint just charges a flat rate. They don't have a higher rate for gas, but I don't know what the delivery charge, because PG&E charges more for delivery if you go above the baseline. So I don't know if this number also changes. I've never been there, so I don't know. Anyway, CARE, California Alternate Rates for Energy, like I said, it's about a 20% discount, and I think that also waives this minimum delivery charge. So I worked out some example bills in therms, which is what the utility bills. A therm is 100,000 BTU or British thermal units. It's also equal to 29.3 kilowatt hours. And if you look up the price, you're looking at between 3 and 4 cents per kilowatt hour that you're paying for gas, compared to maybe 12 cents for electricity. Big difference, you know, a quarter to a third the price for gas compared to electric. But anyway, what I did was worked out some hypothetical bills, assuming 0 to 20 therms per month. This is the CenterPoint bill. This would be PG&E with the CARE program, PG&E with the retail program. These numbers are probably close, but I wouldn't bet money on them being exactly right. This is just based on my understanding of that previous spreadsheet. And then what I did was plotted them here on the side. Here's the CARE program. It's just a straight line. Here's the CenterPoint bill. Also a straight line, but it starts at $5. And then here's the PG&E retail rates. And you can see up at 20, it's starting to close in. And if you get up here to about 30 therms, these two lines are going to cross. So if you're using more than 30, might make sense to go with somebody like CenterPoint. But I've decided it doesn't make sense because I'm down here. In May, I went ahead and I had my 12 months of data, so I sent in my paperwork, and I got my June bill from the gas company, and it was indeed less, so that's a good thing. So yeah, if you have any questions about this data, post up in the comment section below, and I'll put some of the other tankless water heater videos over here on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.